Hi everyone, I would like to quickly demonstrate how to make an accessible course policies page in your Canvas shell. So I will start by clicking into my course and I will find the modules link on the left menu. Then I will click the icon to create a new module and I will give it the title Orientation. Once the module is created, I can then use the plus icon in the upper right corner to add a page. It is a new page, and I'm going to call it Course Policies and add the item. Now that the page exists, I will click into it and click the Edit button in the upper right-hand corner. This will open my text editing box and the rich content editor at the top of the screen. I'm going to go over and grab my course policies and copy and paste them into the text box. Once here, one trick that I like to do if I'm copying and pasting from a document is to remove any stray formatting. So I'm going to click Control A to highlight everything, and then use the clear formatting icon. And that just removes any odd formatting from Google Docs or Microsoft Word. Now I want to go ahead and apply some accessible elements to this page. The first thing I'm going to practice doing is marking my headings. So this is each of my policies really needs to be distinguished on the page, which is important for students, for example, using a screen reader, but it also looks good for everyone. So I simply highlight the item that I want to be a heading, and I go up to the editor and change it from paragraph text to header 2. In Canvas, you always start with header 2. So I'm going to go through and label all of my policies as header 2. Now, if I have any subheadings within these categories, I can label those as heading 3. They do have to go in order to be properly nested. So this one does have a few subheadings. Highlight those. Those are going to be header 3s. Great. So I've got my headings applied. It's starting to look better, I think. Now I want to practice using the list tool in Canvas. And again, we want to use the list that is available on the rich content editor. We don't want to create our own lists by typing numbers. That actually does not work to make the code accessible to somebody using assistive technology. So anywhere that I have a list on my page, I'm not going to use dashes or numbers or asterisks. Instead, I'm going to highlight it and use a bullet list or a numbered list. I usually use bulleted lists unless the list is something I want them to do in a particular order. Or if the list is something, like if I'm saying, please complete, answer the following three questions, then I would want to use a numbered list. But otherwise, the bulleted list will put them into a nice list for you. And the third thing to practice with is links and making sure that any hyperlinks you have on your page are accessible. So let's look. Yes, we do have some long URLs. This is not good for somebody using assistive technology because it will read the entire URL to them and it will be meaningless. So what we want to do is we want to actually make some of our text the link so it's very descriptive. I'm going to actually just Control X, cut my URL, and insert it where I actually want it. So I'm going to highlight Cabrillo's Academic Integrity Policies. And here I can use the link to URL tool to paste in my URL, or I can press Control K and copy in my URL here in this menu. And that's what it looks like. Now they know where that link is going to. It can be understood out of context, which is important for assistive technology. Let me do my second link. Again, instead of a long URL, I'm going to insert it right into the text. Okay, so now I've got headings, lists, and links. I'll click Save. Take a look at my beautiful policies page. There's one thing left to do. If I go back to my modules page, everything is here, but it's not published, so nobody can see it. So I want to go ahead and publish the item by clicking the publish icon on the right side and publish the overall module, the orientation module, by again clicking that icon. And that's it. Let us know if you have any questions.